And if I did, I'd pay for them.
I are a nut at all. What's a few carrots between friends, huh?
Do you know that's the trouble with you? You're too easy going. There's no way to run a business.
Ah, we belong enough dead, as the fella says.
I'll see you.
Right, yeah.
Cheers.
Oh, Michelle, you what? But you're frightened.
Sorry, mate. Sorry, I just slipped out of the pub for a few minutes.
Well, what can I do for you?
Nothing. Just come to pay something off me bill.
What bill?
I have an outstanding bill with you, Miley.
Ah, sure, so is half the town. It's the times we live in. I wouldn't have thought of it at all any further you reminded me of it.
Yeah, but she thought of it, and she made no bones about saying it. She'd be in front of other customers, too.
Carmel, is it?
Yeah. Here you are now, Miley. I'll pay the balance next week.
Oh, but there's no hurry with it.
No, Miley. Never let it be said. I'd better get back. Give my love to Biddy.
I will. And thanks.
Sorry, Teasy. Had a bit of business with Miley.
Oh, that's all right, love.
Is it Carmel making a great fist to us?
Of what?
The shop.
She has it lovely, and she's so efficient.
She's efficient, all right. Something that cowboy she's married to.
Ah, they've had a rough time.
Teasy, we've all had a rough time, but we don't talk of sponging off the state.
Who's sponging off the state?
Well, they come back here because they can't make it in England and then expect to be supported as though we all owed them a living or something.
Who took your bone, madam?
Oh, by the way, I've signed maternity form.
Oh, thanks.
Here we are.
Yes. And that's not sponging.
I never said it was.
And every penny of that.
Hi, Miley.
How are you doing?
Great.
Did you have a good holiday?
Oh, don't be talking.
I'll get that.
Oh, thanks. It was a great time. We need a week to recover.
And tell me, how's David?
Oh, this is Gary. We met on holidays. Thanks. Gary, meet Miley.
Huh? How are you?
How are you, Gary?
Bye.
Who's he?
That's my new boyfriend. Isn't he gorgeous?
Once kids have discovered the delicious taste of Petit Filou with its super creamy texture, they just can't get enough. Everyone's little favourite, Petit Filou from Yoplait.
This autumn, Mace and Super Save brings you Victorian Orchard. This magnificent five-piece dinner set can be yours for just $6.99 with tokens. Buy these matching mugs for only $1.69 each and complete the set with this beautiful three-piece tea set.
There's a bright new face.
Imagine you could win whatever you want.
I'll bring my teddy to Disneyland.
I'd love a free childminding service.
I'd love to be pampered on a health farm.
I'd like a Harley Davidson.
Win whatever you want in the Great Bisto Gravy Granules competition.
Bop with the drop. Tickets for the gig, HMV Dublin Cork and Cork Opera House. Guinness Jazz Cork, October 92.
Uh-huh. Dr. Hanlon, I presume. You're welcome back.
Thank you.
And what can I get you? Are you on due?
No, I'll have a glass of Guinness. Be welcome change from all that Cuba Libre stuff.
Oh, yeah. Desperate tack.
Mm. Has Stephen Brennan been around yet?
No, he wasn't, no. Listen, how was the holiday?
Oh, great, great.
And when did you get back?
Just this morning.
Had a good time, though?
Fine. The best.
And, what about Fidelma?
She had a great time, too. We both had a great time.
Yeah, she's a great girl, Fidelma.
Yeah, the best.
Of course, you're engaged now, aren't you?
Oh, yes, we're both engaged to each other.
That's good.
Was it serious? Between you two, Fidelma and you?
Oh, no. There's nothing like that. Just a bit of a rave up, you know?
Ah. She been in it all yet?
No, she wasn't. You could ring Barnes.
No, it doesn't matter. I'm on my way up there anyway. Let's see how Betty is.
Ah, right.
So there's no problem. Well, cheers.
Cheers.
Ah, oh, there you are, Doctor. Nice to see you back.
Ah, Mr. Byrne.
Evening, Doctor. Hey, could you put up a couple of pints there for two thirsty men?
Actually, Mr. Brennan, I was looking for you.
Oh, I was at the mart with Diddy.
Can I have a quick word?
Ah, you can, of course. Excuse me a minute, Diddy.
Hi, Stephen.
Hi, Teasy.
Ah, I thought I heard your voice.
Oh, hiya, Teasy.
Did you see Dick Moran?
Oh, sure, we were at the mart all day.
He was asking for you earlier on.
Oh. Did he say Anne?
No, then I didn't ask him
anything. My God, no, that's great. Will you have a drink?
No, I'm fine, thanks, Mr. Brennan. Over there.
Monday week, you say?
Yeah, the 19th. So, you should have a letter confirming that in the next few days?
You know, that's the best news I had all day.
Well, I'll be in touch.
Thanks very much, Doctor. Thanks very much.
Okay.
Hey, Diddy! Listen. You'll never guess what he's after telling me.
Oh, in the name of... How would I know what he's after telling you?
He's after telling me that I'm going to get me bad eye fixed on Monday week.
I don't see what the fuss is all about. It just didn't work out.
And where's the doctor now?
I'm not really sure. You see, Gary was on a different flight from us, so I asked Dave to swap tickets with him so Gary and I could be together. I organised it.
And he agreed?
Sure, why wouldn't he? He and I weren't talking. Miley, I don't see what the fuss is about.
Look, you can't go on holidays with one fella and come back from holidays with another fella.
Why not?
Because you were supposed to be engaged with the first fella.
Yeah, well, we're not now. And it's no big deal.
Well, that's the best, Jet. You know, you're the coolest customer I've ever come across. Have you no conscience at all,
Miley, I told you, it just didn't work out. Although, I have to say it for him, he was very good. He moved out for the last couple of days.
Oh. And, was he annoyed?
Sure, he didn't seem to be.
Holy God.
Listen, I have to go into video. I'm dying to see her.
Well, listen, hold on a minute now. Hold on. You're to say nothing about this to her. She'd be very upset. She was very fond of David. We were all very fond of him.
He's not dead, you know.
Glasses. Open that, will you? Yeah. I get my wrong glasses.
What?
And it's not cold enough, but what the hell?
Kevin, would you mind telling me what's going on?
Hey, don't say a word. Now, get that down you first. I just had the most fantastic day.
Did you get a raise?
No.
They fired you.
Took the day off.
Oh, Kevin, that's a bit stupid. You know Mark's just looking for the chance to shaft you.
I'm worried about Mark Tully. I have his number.
Ah, Kevin, stop messing around. What happened?
Here's to the beginning of a new life. Well, you could show a little bit of enthusiasm.
What new life?
Here's the bills. Hold on, red ones first. ESB 160, fuel 220, telephone 105. How's the telephone bill that much?
Look,
that's
Kevin.
You talking to your Elmer. Now, hold on. There's 5 ton. Now, what's left?
Kevin, where did all this money come from?
Uncle Joe.
Who's Uncle Joe?
A horse came in this afternoon at Punchestown at 11 to 1.
How much did you win?
Oh, you better sit down for this. Yeah, come on, come on. Now, are you ready? $3,000.
Three what?
3,000 plus.
Oh, my God.
We should go out and celebrate, you know.
No, no, hang on a minute, Kevin. No, I just need a chance to take this in. I was worried about you.
Well, there's no worries now, kiddo.
I know, but I mean, how do we get this way? I knew we were a bit strapped for cash, what with the mortgage and everything. But then when you had to go to the pawn and I heard you had the tab in the pub, I mean, I just didn't think we were that bad.
Well, we're on the pig's back now. Here, pay off me tab, will you?
Pay that off yourself.
All right.
You know you bet on horses.
I only bet on winners.
How often?
When I get the nod. A bloke in work has a sister living with a jockey.
Oh, lovely. Uncle Joe?
Uh-huh.
And what did you say the price was?
11 to 1.
So that means that the bet was about £250.
About that.
Kevin, where did you get £250?
Well, it's all a bit technical. See, I had a good touch the other day. Picked out three £10 doubles and a £10 treble. They all came in, so I decided to throw the lot in Uncle Joe. When the chance comes, you have to take it, Mickey. with both hands.
Listen, look, now, mind his feet there in the gap now. That's all you have to worry
about. You think it was an elephant at Duffy's circus?
Well, Bill, are you in trouble?
We're not in trouble. It's only a cat. Mind.
Grand calf, he is too. God bless him. Come on, get in there. Fine calf. That's the way you do it now. The punch of duty man says. Watch the fingers. Now, so, how's the mart?
Oh, the prices were right.
Sold the lambs?
We sold well, too.
Good. Good we got.
The divil's children have the divil's own luck.
Where does that leave me, Stephen, I wonder? Huh?
Yeah, no offence. Look, lads, I'm off.
Good luck.
Stephen, thanks for all the help.
I'm sure I'll catch you again. Good luck, lads.
Good luck, Stephen. Something wrong with your leg, is there?
There's nothing wrong with my leg. It's me hip.
Oh. Is it hurting you?
I yucked it this morning and lifted up the lambs, I think. I'll rub something on it tonight.
Oh, right. Do you want to come up for your tea?
No, thanks. No. I have to see that calf sucks. Then I have to see Dick Moore and Teasley. Teasley said he was looking for him.
Oh, well, will I run you over?
No, thanks. No. The walk will probably loosen me out of it.
Oh, well, I hope it's a bit of good news.
This family could do with a bit, God knows.
Too true.
James, you can't rush these people. I'll get back onto them if you like, but their instructions to me are to hang on. What? Well, of course your check is safe. I've lodged it. James, if anything happens, you'll be the first to know. I promise you that. Right, goodbye now. Bye-bye. James O'Driscoll.
I met him the other day. He was asking if he had any news for him.
Let him stew. He'll do him good.
Will you look at the expression on Mary Ann's face? Gosh, you don't feel it blowing up, do you?
No.
Hello, the house.
Oh, we're in here, Dinny.
Ah, Dinny, how are you?
Oh, we got Mary. You've done a great job on this place, huh?
Oh, thanks very much. I'm glad you like it. Well, it'll be better when it's all organised and that, you know.
Teaser said you wanted to see me, Dick.
Oh, that's right. I do indeed.
Okay, I'll leave you to it.
I hope it's not bad news.
No, as a matter of fact, it's very good news, Dinny. They've agreed to void the contract.
Oh, my God.
But now, as far as the deposit goes... They're going to give that back as well. Less 10% now for currency difference and administrative charges and all that sort of thing. I could challenge it, of course, but I think we should take the money and run.
Run, Dick, run.
They could delay you now for about 2 weeks.
Look, Dick, I'm in no hurry, no hurry at all. I can tell you, it's going to be a great weight off of my mind.
Indeed, let it be a lesson to you.
Yeah.
Now, do you want something to celebrate?
I'll chop these up for you now.
Miley, are you sure you don't mind me going out?
Oh, not at all.
Only, Gary's taking me to pictures. We might go for a bite to eat afterwards.
Oh, of course. Well, you know your own, though, don't you?
Do you want me to give you a hand now?
No. We'll grant you. We're all organised. I'll feed the girls, and then I'll bring something into Biddy, and I'm sure my father'll drop in after a while.
Oh, sure. Oh, there's Gary.
Oh, yeah. Now, where is she going? Where is that lady going now? I wonder. Do you want some of this?
Hello, Miley.
Oh, Davis, be God. It's yourself.
Yeah, I just dropped in to see how Biddy was doing.
Oh, Biddy, she'd need about a half a stone of valium, I think.
I'll do my best. I'll have a quick word, okay?
Yeah.
How are you?
I'm fine. When did you get back?
Just this morning.
Nice flight?
Very uneventful.
Okay, I better go.
Later on, is there any chance you might be in the pub?
Possibly, although it's hard to tell. It might be very late. Bye, Miley. Bye, girls.
Bye. Well, that's the way.
Yes.
Tis. The evens are pulling in.
Oh, a doctor, are you? I thought that was you off in the car. Oh, God.
Mr. Byrne, you okay?
No, I'll have to sit down for a bit.
You look as if you're in a bit of pain.
No, it's only the old hip. It'll pass.
Well, do you want me to take a look at it?
No. Not at all.
Are you sure now? I'm sure you drop into the surgery if it keeps on giving you trouble now, okay?
Well, sure, he's a very stubborn old fella.
Okay. Well, I'll just have a word with Biddy now, okay?
Oh, well, I'll just let her know that you're here. All right?
Mary Ann?
Yeah.
and you had a great time in Spain.
Come in now, come in.
Well, I won't stay now, Stephen. I only dropped over to give you this. I nearly forgot all about it, to be honest with you.
Oh, thanks very much. Oh, there's some class of a label there.
Oh, yeah. I had it in getting serviced. Well, I wish you the best of luck with it now, because, to be honest with you, it was never really my scene.
Ah, well, you see, you have to have a certain journalistic knowledge to get the best out of these things.
I suppose you do, yeah. You know how to work it, do you?
Oh, I do, I do. Though, mind you, I won't be getting much out of it now for a couple of weeks. I'm getting the other eye done.
Oh, well, that's great. Well, if I see you in the pub, I'll buy you a drink.
Aye, right. Oh, Kevin, I'm glad there's no hard feelings.
Not at all, Stephen. Life is too short for hard feelings.
So you're in then?
I surely am. And you know what? I have Dick to thank for it.
Listen, we'll have to get someone to run the place.
I thought you were going to do that yourself.
Not at all. I'm too busy here. No, Dibby, you need somebody with experience. And I've got an idea.
What?
You know Carmel.
The mad fella's wife.
Listen, watch what you're saying.
So she's already working for Miley down at the shop.
Yeah, but only till Betty comes back. Now, I've been watching her. She'd be great. And another thing.
What?
I heard that she ran an all-night hamburger joint at Portobello while they were in London. She'd be perfect.
Fidelma. Nice to see you.
Hi.
Can I get you a drink or something?
Look, David, I really don't think there's any point.
Oh, come on. Why not? Not even for old time's sake, huh?
All right. I have a Cuba Libre.
Okay.
So have you been here long?
No. I just arrived. Had a lot of cleaning up to do then, the surgery, you know?
Hey, Thelma.
Hi, Rory.
Oh, listen, I heard you had a great time.
Oh, who told you that?
Well, himself here. I think he thought you were never coming. It's a long time since I've seen anyone make a half pint last as long as that one.
A Corona by the neck with a slice of lemon, please, Rory.
Corona.
And a Cuba Libre.
Libre.
Thank you.
Sorry it's so long. The local cop wouldn't let me park on the footpath.
It's all right. You remember David, don't you?
Sure I do. Hi, Dave.
Hello again, Gary.
You coming to bed, Dick?
In a minute.
Okay, don't be long.
Hello, Mark. It's Dick Moran here. Sorry to ring you so late. Listen, do you remember our discussion the other day? Yeah, well, I think I'll take you up on that offer. Of course I have the money. Now, when are we going to meet? 3 o'clock, I'll be there. Bye.